Together with our different intentions, we now begin our celebration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent with the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who showed the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all hope for the faith they profess, and counted Christians, the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and strive after all that has been honored through Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The first reading, a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The way of the just is smooth, the path of the just you make level. Yes, for your way and your judgments, O Lord, we look to you. Your name and your title are the desire of our souls. My soul yearns for you in the night. Yes, my spirit within me keeps vigil for you. When your judgment dawns upon the earth, the world's inhabitants learn justice. O Lord, you mete out peace to us, for it is you who have accomplished all we have done. O Lord, oppressed by your punishment, we cried out in anguish under your chastising. As a woman about to give birth, writhes and cries out in her pains, so were we in your presence, O Lord. We conceive and ride in pain, giving birth to wind. Salvation we have not achieved for the earth. The inhabitants of the world cannot bring it forth. But your dead shall live, their corpses shall rise. Awake and sing, you who lie in the dust. For your dew is a dew of light, and the land of shades gives birth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. From heaven the Lord looks down on the earth. From heaven the Lord looks down on the earth. You, O Lord, abide forever, and your name through all generations. You will arise and have mercy on Zion, for it is time to pity her. For her stones are dear to your servants, and her dust moves them to pity. From heaven the Lord looks down on the earth. The nations shall revere your name, O Lord, and all the kings of the earth your glory. When the Lord has rebuilt Zion and appeared in his glory, when he has regarded the prayer of the destitute and not despised their prayer, from heaven the Lord looks down on the earth. Let this be written for the generation to come. Let these future creatures praise the Lord. The Lord looked down from his holy height. From heaven he beheld the earth, to hear the groaning of the prisoners, to release those doomed to die. From heaven the Lord looks down. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest, says the Lord. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said, "Come to me, all who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves, for my yoke is easy and my burden light." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Very wonderful invitation to all of us that Jesus puts across our mind in the different challenges, burdens, and crosses that we carry, more so as we participate in his own vineyard. The words that somehow tie up to this gospel and make a very wonderful invitation to the gospel acclamation. Come to me, all you who labor and heavy laden, and I give you rest. As human beings, we always try for happiness, and we try as much as possible to have a life that is burden free. We try as much as possible to avoid anything that can stress us, anything can bring us pain. We all want to enjoy life. Unfortunately, it may not necessarily be achieved through the material things or wealth that we have. We have seen so many rich people stinting rich, and yet very unhappy. And yet we have seen many people we consider as misers to the world standards, but they have such incredible peace of mind within themselves. At times, the more we have, the more restless and anxious we become. Is whether we let it or not, we all sometimes get weighed down by life challenges, rich or poor, young or old, educated or not. No one is spared of the ups and downs of life. Jesus, aware that such moments will come, makes such a beautiful invitation. He lived in our human condition. He went through the challenges in gospel, and therefore he spoke out of experience and he said, "Come to me, all your who labor and are heavy burdened, and I will give you rest." He calls all of us who labor and are burdened to come to him so that we can have peace of mind, so that we can have, or he can give us a rest. You can do so by getting down on your knees and pouring all your frustrations, your challenges to him in prayer. You can also do so by coming to the Blessed Sacrament, sitting down before our Lord and pouring out your heart to him, just as Anna, who prayed and vowed to God concerning her child business, and God blessed her with a child. Jesus invites us to take his yoke and learn from him. Carrying Jesus' yoke entails following the narrow and difficult road of obedience to God's commandments amidst the challenges of life, while patterning our own lives to his without allowing ourselves to be controlled by the worries of the world. It entails trying your best every day to doing what is right in the midst of the troubles that we may be facing. We know that it is easier to believe in God or to obey his commandments when life is going in your favor, when life is going on smooth, than when you are sad, when you are angry and depressed. Yet it becomes a yoke to carry. Nonetheless, however tough this yoke may be or may seem to be, it becomes light when, moved by faith and trust, we turn to Jesus rather than seeking consolation and solutions in world needs that end up disappointing us and frustrating us. This is all that Jesus invites us to do in today's gospel. Come to me. With all your burdens, come to me. With all your challenges, come to me. There's no better consolation and strength that you get unless we go to the source of strength, challenging us to keep our faith burning and never allow problems to diminish it. And the Lord, at his own proper time, will always intervene. And so, do not turn away from righteousness because of the troubles and the challenges that you may face. Today's first reading, Isaiah declares that the Lord makes level the way of the just and brings salvation to him. But it calls for a lot of patience as we wait for the Lord to intervene. He also invites us to be humble and gentle, to learn from him, for his gentle and humble of heart, and then we shall find rest for our souls. Our prayer, my dear brothers and sisters, is that the Lord may increase our faith in the midst of the different challenges that we meet in this challenging world, and grant us the grace of patience as we journey through the different crosses that we carry. For the church, may she always be heaven for those who labor and are heavily burdened, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, may the Spirit of God guide and empower them in ways of charity, justice, and mercy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who labor and provide for their loved ones, may the Lord bless them and protect them from harm, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered in this holy place, may God's grace enable us always to give thanks to him, who show us the path to salvation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, members of our parish community, members of our individual families, especially Vicky Akarano, whom we are praying for, may they rest in your life in the glory of heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We now take a moment of prayers that lie in the silence of our hearts. we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear prayer.
We ask for this new Christ.
Amen.
Therefore,
as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you all the prayer and the chance of salvation, giving thanks that you have helped us well to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring under the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Timothy our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Our mercy and us will pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have visited throughout the ages, we may make to become heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. The Lord's command and moved by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, we pray, from every evil. Grace us, grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace, I leave you my peace, I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grace us, grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And now let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world.
Grant us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, have mercy on me, and my soul. But on the sins of the world, my soul has your
Thank you.
is holy. O sacrament divine,
all praise and all thanks be
ever holy and
O sacrament is holy.
O sacrament divine,
all praise and all thanks
be ever holy.
Let us pray. Having one room this evening, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, it is having effect upon us in all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with you.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.